All right, so we will find out, Skip, 8 Eastern tomorrow on ESPN. The draft goes down, but let's talk about the quarterbacks. All the buzz with who is going to go number one, just like when it happened in 2005 when the Niners were deciding between Alex Smith and Aaron Rodgers. Now, former Niners coach Mike Nolan said the decision was made to go with the safe pick in quarterback Alex Smith over, quote, cocky and arrogant Aaron Rodgers with the number one overall pick in the 2005 NFL draft. Stephen A., big mistake here to take Smith over Rodgers, your boy.
Where's Mike Nolan working? Where's he working, Skip?
Answer the question. Answer the question, Skip. Where is Mike Nolan working at right now?
Next question.
Where is he working at
next
right
question.
Now? Is he working someplace? Yeah. Where is Mike Nolan?
Well, I heard from him yesterday.
I rest my case.
Yeah,
we heard from him.
I know he's still alive.
We know he's still alive. We just don't know if he's employed.
Yeah.
I wonder why. Okay. Mm-hmm. Look, I like Alex Smith. I've chided him for being a game manager in the past, but the man doesn't turn the ball over for the most part. He's a talent. He can run a football team. He doesn't knock your socks off. He's above average. Okay, and the Kansas City Chiefs have gotten to the playoffs, and I think Andy Reid, who I love, has done a wonderful job with him, okay?
Mm-hmm.
But the reality is there's only one boy.
No,
that's a bad man.
Yeah,
we know who that is. And it ain't Brick from General Hospital. Mm-hmm. Like my man Sonny Corinto said. He said, you're a bad man.
You said, he said
about me, and I appreciate it. But the flip side is that it's really about Aaron Rodgers. That is the bad man. Aaron Rodgers is the greatest talent at the quarterback position my eyes have ever seen. And I'm here to tell you something right now. These scouts, and I'm being serious here, taking all of this aside, because I'm not going to chide Mike Nolan. Mistakes happen. Nobody's perfect. I get all of that. But Skip, seriously, as somebody who's covered the NFL for over 30 years, for crying out loud, help me out here. Help me understand this. Doesn't it annoy you when you hear these talent evaluators and it's like they're looking for excuses not to pick somebody? Aaron Rodgers, you got off-the-field issues, that would be different. You got physical ailments, that would be different.
Mm-hmm.
He's cocky, arrogant. That's why.
Don't you want that?
That's why. You're damn right you want that from the quarterback position. You want a guy that's going up in it, please, I got this. Give me the football. Move out the way. I know what I'm doing. You want the quarterback to have that mentality. You want him to be unflappable. You want him to have intestinal fortitude. You don't want him being somebody looking like Jay Cutler, just a tad bit removed from the from depression or crying out loud. Not to knock those out there who's got depression, but I keep saying it. The only time I've ever seen Jay Cutler smile was when he was signing his new contract. That's it. Outside of that, he's a perpetual piece of depression.
That's how he looks.
Wait a second.
Is this a Jay Cutler question? How did he get in there?
I'm saying to you,
completely gratuitous cheap shot.
Yeah, it was. But the point that I'm trying to make to you is this: when you talk about Aaron Rodgers, I see a dude that was on the radio when he's telling everybody R-E-L-A-X, relax.
Yeah.
I see Joe Cool. I see that demeanor. I see that swag.
Mm-hmm.
I see it in Tom Brady, too, of course, no doubt. But I see it in Aaron Rodgers. I see it in Drew Brees to some degree, of course. But I see it in Aaron Rodgers.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm like this. You watching Aaron Rodgers come out of college and Alex Smith, and you talking about Alex Smith had all the necessary credentials and Aaron Rodgers, it basically came down to he was arrogant? Really? That just drives me crazy. You know, I get to the point sometimes, Skip, where I don't think these teams should even be allowed to interview dudes.
Mm-hmm.
You should watch the tape and do an investigation into their history and leave it at that, because the nonsense that they come up with not to pick certain people is just so egregious to me, it's annoying. Arrogance? That's why.
If that's your knock, you're doing all right.
You picked Alex Smith. You're the San Francisco 49ers. You picked Alex Smith instead of Aaron Rodgers because he was too arrogant. You got to be kidding me. I mean, come on, man. Please.
By the way, I now have a new nickname for my man, Rodgers. He's Arrogant Rodgers, right? Arrogant. I've told you. Listen, and again, no knock on him. He's still arrogant. He's still cocky.
And what's wrong with it?
Okay.
I'm just saying, tell me what's wrong with it. Tell me what's wrong with the
arrogance. You got to believe in yourself
first. There's nothing wrong with it. Occasionally, it's a little much. And I must say, he has not been able to back up his arrogance over the last couple of years because the bad man has often, too often by his standards, just been bad, especially last year. You know it, and I know it, but I'm going to move on.
Last year was not a good year.
Thank you. Thank you.
According to his standards.
Yes, by his standards. Okay.
Yes.
Now, what happened? They also, by the way, Scott McLuhan, who's now the GM in Washington, was also part of this decision that Mike Nolan made. What have I told you? Let's look back at what they said. Number one, arrogant. What have I told you? And it mostly applies to me in all my time covering the National Football League, which goes way back. This mostly applies to white coaches with white quarterbacks pre-draft. They fall in love with the kid. Like, he's such a coachable kid. Remember, Mike Nolan was the son of Dick Nolan, a guy I covered who was a former Cowboy coach. He goes way back before your time, former New Orleans head coach. He's old school. And I'm sure he looked in Alex Smith's eyes and said, what a great kid this is. Aaron Rodgers, God, he put me off a little bit. You know, come on, is he really that full of himself? Is he really that great? Because he wasn't that great at Cal. His mechanics were a disaster at Cal. And Mike Nolan said yesterday, we knew it was going to be a big project to rebuild his mechanics.
So they didn't want to work.
Okay.
So they didn't want to work.
All right. But remember, they needed to throw somebody into the fire immediately because that team in San Francisco was 2-14. Ted Thompson had just taken over in Green Bay. They got Aaron Rodgers at 24. You know why they got him at 24? Because their quarterback was Brett Favre. And so they had a good team already. And what happened in Green Bay? Aaron Rodgers got to go sit for not 1 year, not 2 years, 3 years he got to sit. And you said,
but we all know that was about Brett Favre.
Okay, but it was also
Aaron
about.
Was worried. It was
it
ready.
Was also about.
3 years.
Mike McCarthy and company, when he took over, they had to rebuild Aaron's throwing motion. And I agree with you.
That's
it
fair.
Is beautiful
that's
to watch, but they did.
Okay.
And by the time he was finally ready, it was 3 years in, and Brett Favre was at the end. So it was right
Skip,
on schedule.
Skip, the last, okay. Now you can make an argument that, no, first of all, I will not dispute that Aaron Rodgers sitting down the first year. That was a given. I get that. I understand that. And you do make a compelling argument that San Francisco had to get somebody to insert in there.
They threw him into the fire at that particular moment.
That's fair. But the flip side to it, Skip, is that Mike McCarthy and those guys, whatever work they do, either they're magicians or Aaron Rodgers had a lot of ability and was able to adjust, because by year two, he was ready to go because they were talking about Brett Favre leaving then. But obviously, you couldn't push Brett Favre out the door. So don't give me year two and three that Aaron Rodgers sat down when he was ready to go, but Brett Favre didn't want to leave. Okay, until he was pushed out.
Was Aaron really ready when he finally got a shot?
Listen,
yes, he was.
Let me tell you something. He was ready when he got a shot, and there's no doubt about that, and I understand that. His first year, when he started 16 games, he completed 63.6%. I got a computer.
Just
you got your notes.
Up.
I got a computer.
I don't have a computer.
Well, I'm helping you.
I'm at a huge disadvantage here.
Oh, you got notes. Stop it.
I'm not knocking you for not knowing.
I do have a computer.
That is a lie because you write down everything, so stop it. But here's the point. Okay, thank you very much. Aaron Rodgers, first year, started all 16 games. He threw for 4,038 yards.
Oh, he was good.
28 touchdowns, 13 interceptions.
Well, that playoff
first
game,
year, okay?
He wasn't so good.
Won a Super Bowl, okay? Last year was a bad year. Bad year!
Yeah, thank you.
We agree.
Yeah.
For Aaron Rodgers, let me tell you what a bad year for Aaron Rodgers is. Please allow me to do this.
So.
Started all 16 games. Finished 10-6. I mean, he only completed 60.7% of his passes. I mean, that's just terrible. Just terrible. Terrible. Aaron Rodgers. Oh, my God. Okay. 3,821 yards. That's not Aaron Rodgers. 31 touchdowns, 8 interceptions. A quarterback rated of 92, a QBR of 64. That is a bad year for Aaron Rodgers. At some point in time, when is Skip Bayless? Because, you know, you've been covering the NFL for so long. You are the leader of the pack. When are you going to step up? When are you going to hold yourself and other pundits accountable, Skip Bayless, for sitting up when are you and other pundits going to hold NFL officials accountable? If you can't foresee certain things, why do you have your job? You're not playing. Your job is to see some of this stuff. And I understand taking Alex Smith first under your premise. My point is, we're talking about the quarterback position. We're talking about a guy in Aaron Rodgers that's been at the helm the last 8 or 9 years that could literally go 8 or 9 years
more. I got it.
Why? Okay, can't they see
by
that?
By the way, can I throw in one last stat out of the back of my head?
Sure.
Probably wrong.
That you wrote down somewhere. Go ahead. Go ahead.
No, this is recall.
I got a lot of recall, too. Go ahead.
Since the Packers and Aaron Rodgers won their only Super Bowl a decade ago, what is he now? 2-4 in the postseason? I forget. I'm hazy on the stat. But he hasn't been very good in the playoffs since then. And I know for a fact he's lost a couple of home games in the playoffs, which is not a pretty sight for somebody you call the greatest quarterback you've ever seen throwing the football. Now, back to Alex Smith. Sometimes it's right place, right time for Aaron Rodgers. Wrong place, wrong time for an Alex Smith. Are you saying Alex Smith is a bust? I think he gets a bad rap because he is not Jamarcus Russell, right?
I don't believe
he's not.
He's certainly not Jamarcus Russell. Alex Smith is a really nice game managing quarterback.
He is. So he gets thrown into the fire for a team that goes 4-12 the first year and he starts 7 games. Then they go 7-9, 5-11, 7-9, 8-8, 6-10. And then Harbaugh comes in, a real quarterback coach, and they go 13-3 with Alex Smith. So he's capable of managing the game at that high of a level.
Yeah. But are you winning because of him or in spite of him? Or neither. You know what you're doing? He's along for the ride. Green Bay wins because of Aaron Rodgers.
Okay, but there are times under Andy Reid. There are times under Andy Reid that they have won because of Alex Smith.
Alex
He's been
Smith,
really good.
Alex
he
Smith,
is 30-16 as a starter under Andy
Reid. And I'm not knocking that. But the problem is, on too many occasions when we watch Alex Smith, when you need plays to be made, when you need someone to lead, when you are trailing and you're operating behind the eight ball and you need somebody to step up and be like, I'm going to get it done, someone that strikes fear, he's not that guy. When I think about an Aaron Rodgers, when I think about Tom Brady or Drew Brees, you're going like this.
Right.
Man, just keep the ball away from them. Don't let them get the ball back. You don't give a damn if Alex Smith gets the ball. You ain't worried about him the way you worry about other guys.
Do you remember the playoff game against Andrew Luck, your man, at Indy? Remember that?
Yes.
When they lost 45-44, and Alex Smith lit them up for 44 points.
You mean when they had that huge lead and Indianapolis came back?
They collapsed, and that's more the defense than Alex Smith.
The defense collapsed in terms of what they gave up to Andrew Luck. Mm-hmm. But how come the offense couldn't engage a ball control?
They lost everybody. They lost their receivers. I think they lost two running backs.
Well, you always commenting about how Tom Brady don't have anything, but somehow, some way, he makes something happen.
We're talking about the greatest quarterback.
Well, I'm telling you, you never mentioned the word great when it comes to Alex Smith. Period.
Well, I just say he's not a bust. You know, people write
him
off like, okay,
but
it wasn't that.
He's average.
It was a closer call than people give this credit for, because he has lived up for a long period of time to being at least a top, I'm going to say a top 15 quarterback. Is that fair?
Well, I'm serious.
How many teams in the league? All right, I'll go top 10. I'll say he's the 10th best quarterback.
No. Stick with your original. Go with your gut. The top 15.
Joey Bosa.
That's what you said.
Go Cowboys.
Top 15 in the 30-team league. I'm so touched. Top 15 in the top 30 league. Okay.
All right. You know whose playoff hopes didn't live up for expectations?
Arrogant Rodgers, right?
Oh, I was going to the Clippers.
Yeah. Sorry.
But glad you got that one in real quick.